Happy to see you perform the Paran that you had learnt in the foundation course. You had learnt two more Parans, Chakradar Parans, and this one was not a Chakradar. But we will now concentrate on this Paran because you will learn a Paran which is similar to this one in this year. But it will be a little more complex because after all, you're in second year now, right? Now, before we start learning the Paran, you must tell me which musical instrument is the source of the sound syllables used in a Paran.
Mridang. Mridang.
Right. The sound syllables of a Paran are taken from the mridang. And so we start this Paran using a gesture resembling the playing of a mridang. Like a mridang is a drum which is played from both ends. And the feet are dha te te, dha te te, dha dha te te. Now the Paran that you did just now started with dha ge te 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 te, dha ge te 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 te, dha te te, dha te te, dha dha te te. We leave out the dha ge te 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 te, dha ge te 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 and start with dha te te, dha te te, dha dha te te. And we are moving in the right front direction. Like if this is my center, I'm moving in this corner, or rather towards this corner. Ta te te, ta te te, ta ta te te. The right foot has the body weight on it, and I'm sliding my left foot. Ta te te, ta te te, ta ta te te. Again, dha, flat foot, left foot sliding, te, the heel. Dha, te, te, dha, dha, te, te. And the hand playing the mridang. Dha, te, te, dha, te, te, dha, dha, te, te. You had learnt the love shikha, which was being done here. Instead of doing it up and down in that way, we do it at the same plane, like playing a mridang. So, dha te te, I'm looking here, next dha te te, in this direction, say the same direction in which my body is facing, and again, dha dha te te. Okay? So, would you like to do it together? Dha te dha te te dha dha te te. Again, dha te te dha te dha dha te te. Then, kridha te te is with the pushpak hand and the feet. Kridha te te. Kridha te. You have learned kridha te te before in the first year tukra. Dha dha te te. Kridha te te. So dha te te, dha te te, dha dha te te, kridha te te. So let's do this part several times. Come. Part is dha te te dha ge de ge na thun thun. In dha te te, we go round chakkar. Dha te te, dha te te, right left right foot. Dha te te. Then dha ge de ge na, I'm taking a palta. Sorry, dha ge de ge na, dha ge de ge na, and dha ge de ge na. Right, left, right, left, right. Okay? Then thun thun, if you notice the sound, thun thun, as if something is being pulled. So here we are taking our hands, but instead of just placing them, we are as if pulling the hand. Thun thun, thun thun. And the feet are also going. Thun thun. I'm sliding it and bringing it back. So my body weight is on my right foot and the left is being pulled back and brought back again. Thun thun. And here instead of going straight, I'm going a little downwards. Thun thun. Then again straight. Nage nagi. Ke nage. So dha te te dha ge de ge na thun thun nage nage. Would you like to do this sequence several times? Come. Dha te te circle, dha ge de ge na palta, thun thun, pulling your hand back and coming forward again, then nage nage. Nage nage is just two steps. Nage nage. Dha te te dha ge de ge na thun thun nage nage. Dha te te dha ge de ge thun thun nage nage. Dha te te dha ge de ge thun thun nage nage. Dha te te dha ge de ge thun thun nage nage. So to combine the two, dha te te dha te te dha dha te te kri dha te dha te te dha ge de ge na thun thun nage nage. This we will do several times. Here we have the pushpak hand, which you know very well, and thuna kitak. Here, because as if in thu, the sound is at a higher pitch, so our body is also being raised. And in order to raise our body, we raise our body both from the torso and we are on our toes also. Thuna kitak. Then dhagina nagina, fast paltas. Thagena nagena. Ghennaran you had done in the previous paran. Ghennaran. Dhadhinta, ghennaran, you're going a little towards the left front corner. Ghennaran and in ghin, ghennaran. We are ghennaran. Dhadhinta, it's a slow chakkar, you come back. Dhadhinta, you come back to position. Ketatak dhetta. Okay, so can we do this part again? Remember, we had done up to thun thun nage nage thuna ketatak. We actually start with thuna ketatak dhage na nage naghe nara na dha dhinta ketatak dhetta. Thuna ketatak dhage na nage naghe nara na dha dhinta ketatak dhetta. I know this paran is a little more complicated than the other bowls you have learned, but as we progress, we have to learn more and more difficult things, right? So, please. By now, you have completed more than three quarters of the paran. We just have the tehai left. So can we do it from the beginning up to this point? Come, I'm sure you will do it. Now this time everybody did it correctly, which is good. Then kata ghe ghe tha ghe ghe tha ghe ghe kata. This hand, you know. Now, ghe ghe tha is a new movement. This is called mir, as if you're pulling a sound. In mir, in music, is also when you're pulling a sound, like it begins at one point and is gradually pulled. So here also, the right hand and the left hand are in close relationship. They're parallel to each other. And your body is more or less at the center. Your body also turns, then you come back again. As you're going upwards, the right hand does the larger movement, while coming downwards, the left hand is moving, or rather covering a wider space. You had learnt the Hasta Chakra combination movement. This movement comes in, but instead of doing it with one hand, we are doing it with two hands. So, ghe ghe tha, ghe ghe tha. And the feet are ghe ghe tha, ghe ghe. Ghe ghe tha, ghe ghe tha, ghe ghe tha. Ghe ghe tha, ghe ghe tha, ghe tha. So, kata ghe ghe tha, ghe ghe tha, ghe ghe tha. Let's do this part. Now, we will do it again, but instead of stopping it after one tha, you will do five thas. Okay? Come. So, 5 chakras. End it here or here, but this looks better after a chakkar. So that is the entire Paran. Okay? So let's give it a try from the beginning. Together with the Nagma. The recitation. Now that you remember the movements, the recitation will not be so difficult. It will be easier to remember. A very difficult and a very traditional Paran of the Lucknow Gharana. In the second part of this episode, we will learn 2 more Parans. In this part, we will learn 2 new Parans. To begin with the movements of the first Paran, Ta-dlang, ta-dlang, ta. The feet are ta-dlang, ta-dlang, ta. The dhlang is like a kran, dhlang. But for kran it was a lighter sound, this is a heavier sound. So ta dhlang, ta dhlang, ta. And the hands are ta dhlang, ta dhlang, ta. Dhuma kita tak ta, you go round twice. Dha-dhin-ta, dha-dhin-ta, dha-dhin-ta. This is called artha-alingan. As if I'm trying to hold somebody. Okay? So, dha-dhin-ta, dha-dhin-ta. My body is facing this side. Dha-dhin-ta, dha-dhin-ta. And the last ta, I look in the other direction. Then, kataka dikhne, kataka dikhne, ta. This is called alingan because both hands are used together. So I'm turning to this side now. Kataka dikhne, kataka dikhne. And kataka dikhne is takita, 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 ta. Kataka, kataka. Next is te te ka ta, te te kataka dikhne. Again, circle. take. In takita kita takita. Okay? Takita kita takita. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Takita kita takita. And the hands are urdhasata. Takita takita. Gata gadi khane. Tha, tha, tha. Right foot. Dha, dha, dha. And here it's just plain dha, dha, dha. Then from here, as if I'm cutting the air, my hand was here, I turn my wrist and cut the air and come. Gadi ghene. Ta, ta, ta. Dha, dha, dha. Notice the tehai. It is different from the other tehais you have learnt. Here, instead of the three pallas being the same, here it is gradually becoming smaller, it is diminishing. Kata gadi khene tha ne tha ne tha, gadi khene tha ne tha ne tha, tha ne tha ne tha. Okay? This is another style of a tehai. I mean, it doesn't come down in any haphazard way. It is a gradual diminishing. Okay? So, to remember the movement, tadlang, tadlang, ta, dhumakitak, dhumakitak, tadhinta, dhadhinta, katakadikini, katakadikini, teteka, teteka, takitikita, takita, katakadikini, tan, tan, ta, gadikini, tan, tan, ta, tan, tan, ta. And the pause is like 1, 2. Katakadikini, tan, tan, ta, gadikini, tan, ta. Ta, ta, ta. And now, let's recite it with the music. Now the dance. Good. And now we have one Chakardar Paran left to learn. Here, we will have a new rhythmic style, which will be in units of 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. Dha, ne, dha, ne, dha, ga, dha, ga, dege, 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 nage, 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 te, te, ka, ta, na, te, te, ka, ta, na, te, te, ka, ta, ta, ga, ta, ghi, ne, ta, ka, ta, ta, ge, te, te, ka, ta, ga, di, ghi, ne, ta, ka, ta, ga, ta, ga, ta. Dha, ne, you go round twice, okay? Dha, ne, dha, ne. Dhane dhane, dhagat dhagat. In dhagat dhagat, like dhagat dhagat. So when I'm finishing with the left foot, I'm looking to the left. And when I'm finishing with the right foot, I'm looking to the right. Dhagat dhagat. Okay, so dhane dhane, dhagat dhag. Dege dege dege, nage nage nage. Digi, 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 heel, and the first, of course, is flat. Digi, 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 nage, nage, nage. So, digi, 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 nage, nage, nage. Then, tete katan, tete katan, tete katan. Tete katan, tete katan, tete katan. Then tha ka tha. Ghine tha. Ghine, we are turning towards the back. And this hand you had already done in the hasta chakra combination movement. Ghine tha. Kat tha. Kat tha. Dhage te te. Kata gadi ghine. Then thaka, 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 tha. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. Thaka, 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 tha. So these are easy movements, movements which you have done before. So let's recite the bowl. And this is a chakardar. Remember, you have to do it 3 times. And again, this is a bowl which has rhythmic units of 3 and is called a bowl of tisra jati. Parans, and these are all complicated, and because they are complicated, they are more intricate and very, very beautiful, don't you think so? Yes. So please do practice these, and we will go on further with our lessons. In fact, now I have a surprise for you. We have been learning three taal all this while, right? Yes. We will learn a new taal, Rupak. So, all the best to you. Do practice Trital, because Trital is called the queen of all Taals. If you know Trital well, you can pick up any other Taal with ease. So, do keep on practicing all that you have learned. You are doing very well. I am proud of you. And I want to see you doing better and better. Namaste. Pranam.